9 teams and 18 drivers competing at the 26th Grand Prix of Abu Dhabi. The team to beat is, of course, Team Abu Dhabi, with their current lineup of drivers having won all 5 Grand Prix this year. The world title in 2018 is Team Abu Dhabi's for the taking. Sean Torrente tops the world standings heading into the Grand Prix of Abu Dhabi, but the world title has slipped through his fingers in the final rounds for the past 4 years. Teammate Eric Stark is just 7 points behind Torrente and is a relative newcomer to F1 H2O, with just 5 years on the tour compared to Torrente's 11. He was third last year and is now close to a world championship title.
It's 2 races to go. For sure, the pressure has been turning up a little bit in the team. But we've been here testing. I will do as good as I can. The only thing I can do is go out there and really push the maximum, and then we see how far it goes.
The team has been testing extensively for 2 weeks on home waters, and the rivalry has intensified between the two teammates in pre-race pre-practices.
Yeah, the practice is very, very intense now in the end of the season. Everyone wants to be up there, especially, I think, between me and Sean. Yeah, you need to push.
We're drivers, so you always want a little extra confidence by being P1 or P2 or being faster than your teammate. But then again, we're drivers. We can just take a dump in the morning and have good confidence, so whatever.
And of course, there's Dani Al-Khamzi, a longtime F1 H2O veteran with multiple Grand Prix wins. He's been world number 2, but has never won a race in home waters and never won the championship title. He's determined to finally bring the championship home. Under the guidance of team manager and 10-time F1 H2O world champion Guido Cappellini, all 3 drivers have shown they have what it takes to win, but none has achieved the greatest honor in F1 H2O yet. If anyone can throw a spanner in the works, it's Marit Stromoy, who's been in exceptional form in the last few races, and in India she doggedly powered her way in to finally break the Abu Dhabi podium shutdown.
Yeah, for sure, the 3 guys from Abu Dhabi in top 3, they all need to win this race, and I hope to be there in the middle to shake things up a little bit. I'm going for the podium, but for sure there's a lot of people here that is capable of going there, so we'll see what we can do. I will try my best.
She is 6th in the world standings going into Abu Dhabi, and her role could be crucial. CTIC F1 Shenzhen China team's 2 drivers are 4th and 5th in the world standings, and Peter Marin still has a very slim outside shot at a possible world title in 2018, having had an exceptional year with points in every race and a podium in London. His teammate, 3-time world champion Philip Chiap, had a good start with podiums, but he's out of the running for a 4th world title this year. Team Amaravati is the dark horse, and Jonas Andersson and Eric Eden make formidable challengers who can also shake things up if they can find the technical reliability to do it. The 5-pin circuit in Abu Dhabi is the usual flat yet technical inshore course that features 1 tricky right-hander and 2 long straights that could provide some exciting passing opportunities as always. BRM official qualifying is divided into 3 sessions. At the end of Q1, the field is down to 12 boats who lop horns in Q2 for a top 6 place. In Q3, those remaining 6 boats have 2 laps apiece and the circuit to themselves to lay down their fastest times. The BRM official qualifying is the key to the race and perhaps the single most important factor to success.
So our qualifying formula is really important. We want to start up front. It's hard to pass boats because everybody's so good. So, last 2 races I started from pole and I won the race. It makes it easier on the driver the second day. So if you do the hard work today, hopefully tomorrow it makes it a lot easier. That being said, there's 20 other guys trying to do the same thing. So that's why it's such a fight.
In Q1, Blaze Performance team principal Francesco Cantando carried on his good form from Amaravati, but his teammate Simone Schuft was bumped out. Maverick flag solo in Q1, Supipon Supongbong unable to start. But De Guin was again out in Q1 along with both F1 Atlantic team drivers, Grant Trask and Duarte Benavente. The big surprise in Q1 was struggling three-time world champion Philippe Chiappe, the Frenchman just on the threshold all session until he was unceremoniously bumped out by a late surge by Bartek Marszalek of Emirates Racing Team and Alex Carrella also just squeezing through into Q2. Also eliminated in Q1 was Philip Roms of Mad Croc Baba Racing Team. Q2, bigger stakes, higher tension, intense drama. Early in the session, there was a massive high-speed, big-impact collision between victory driver Ahmed Al-Hamali and Peter Marin of CTIC F1 Shenzhen, China, with Ahmed Al-Hamali coming off worse, crashing out, uninjured, but with serious doubts about whether he could race the next day. As the crash cleared and the circuit ready for the remainder of the Q2 session, with only minutes left, the boats went back out there. Peter Marin's boat was deemed unseaworthy. He was out in Q2.
So I was taking my lap and I think Ahmed was really, really too large and hurt me when I was speeding. So this is the Chaine.
Eric Stark has set the fastest lap time before the crash and he held on to make it through to Q3. Stark's teammate Sean Torrente was struggling in eighth before the crash, and he had to do some serious hustling with precious little time left. It paid off as the man from Miami just made it through into sixth. Marit Stromoy was having a tough time of it in Q2, looking at an early exit, but a brilliant last-minute run from the Norwegian shot her up into second place behind Stark, and she flew through into Q3 at the expense of defending world champion Alex Carrella. Stromoy's teammate Bartek Marszalek was also out in Q2, along with Cantando and Sami Celio. Making it into Q3 alongside Torrente, Stromoy and Stark were Daniel Kamzi and both Team Amaravati drivers Eric Eden and Jonas Andersson. Q3, the final BRM qualifying session. Sean Torrente was out first, knowing what was on the line, knowing he needed to nail this. His time, 44.13, not as fast as Stark's Q2 time, and Torrente knows it may not be enough. Jonas Andersson was out next, and he smoked Torrente's time with a solid 43.88. His Amaravati teammate Eric Eden also beat Torrente's time, but Jonas Andersson held on to provisional pole with three drivers left. World Championship contender Daniel Kamzi puts in a brilliant lap to snatch provisional pole from Andersson, his time 43.25. Next up was Marit Stromoy, the Norwegian powerhouse made no mistakes, racing clean, focused and tight, and she in turn snatched provisional pole from Al-Kamzi with a time of 43.18.
Did a couple of mistakes, but so I don't think it will hold for the pole, but I'm happy with second. If it's second, still number one. Still.
Last man out was Q2 topper Eric Stark, the World Championship hopeful, going all out in a bid for pole. Brilliant, look at that time, 42.81. Eric Stark romps to a BRM qualifying win and takes pole position for the Grand Prix of Abu Dhabi. His world title hopes suddenly looking very good indeed, and Team Abu Dhabi celebrates like they just won the race. Stromoy again starts on the pontoon behind Stark. Next to her in P3 will be Thani Al-Kamzi, followed by Amaravati drivers Andersson and Eden, with Sean Torrente starting in sixth on the pontoon.
Yeah, for sure, this was the plan for this race. You know, I was second in the championship, and the only way for me to win the championship is before Sean. And today we did the job. The guys made a perfect boat for me, so it was a pleasure to drive the boat today.
Preparations for the penultimate race of the year were near completion. Team Abu Dhabi poised to take the World Team Championship here. Veteran Thani Al-Kamzi was also keen to give his title hopes a boost by being the first Abu Dhabi driver. Ever to win in home waters.
I try to start a good start and finish safe race. We'll see what position I get.
Pole pole sitter Eric Stark has every reason to be nervous, as right beside him is Amaravati runner-up Marit Stromoy.
Yeah, basically I have everything to win. He's got everything to lose, and I just have to find the right prop, be fast off the dock, and really try to push through the race.
Now we have 10th position in the start after all the changes what was there, and it will be middle of the pack. It's very difficult to pass here in this race course, so starting 10th it will be very challenging.
The starting lineup, Eric Stark on pole, while his biggest rivals for the world title, Alcamzi and Torrente, are in 3rd and 6th respectively. Morin and Corella are 7 and 8, Schiap in 12th, Philip Roms at the back behind Benavente, Ahmed Alhamali would not be racing after his qualifying crash. All eyes on the contest between Stark, Torrente and Alcamzi. Can Stark steal the lead from Torrente? Can Alcamzi deliver for Abu Dhabi? The countdown was on for the 2018 Grand Prix of Abu Dhabi. The race is on. Start from Eric Stark as Stromoy and Alcamzi pull away from the pole sitter. Look at that! Peter Morin flies past Anderson and Eden, leaving the Amaravati drivers behind as Morin builds on a great start. Bartek Marsalek of Emirates Racing Team pulls ahead of Alex Carella, but on the starboard, it's Sammy Celio speeding out of nowhere from 10th position and leading them all in a spray. First to the commitment buoy is Alcamzi, with Peter Morin and Celio close behind him on the outside, and Stark trying to use that inside lane advantage on the turn. Jonas Andersen is chasing Marit Stromoy on the inside, with Peter Morin on the outside. Andersen trying to hang in the top five. Eric Stark trying to make the most of that inside lane. He cuts the corner tight, but Peter Morin is fast on the outside, and Stark drops another spot in Peter Morin's spray. Behind them, Marit Stromoy emerges from the spray with Celio fighting on the outside. He does it. He passes Stromoy into fourth position. What a start from Celio, up from 10th. Out in the lead is Alcamzi, off to a brilliant start here in his hometown. Drama behind Alcamzi as Eric Stark gives chase to the flying Frenchman, Peter Morin. Morin goes long and wide, Stark cuts in tight, trying to get a jump on Morin, but Morin holds off the Swedish challenge, entering the right-hand yellow buoy ahead of Stark. Behind Marit Stromoy in fifth is a battle for sixth position between Cantando, Anderson, and Torrente. And Cantando overhauls Jonas Anderson, moving up to sixth position after having started back in 11th. As Cantando continues his rise up the field, Sean Torrente is trying to claw his way up after dropping two spots down at the start. Torrente and Anderson lock horns on the straightaway, and Torrente passes Anderson, moving up into seventh. Further back, Eric Eaton has had a bad start and is passed by Bartek Marsalek and then Philip Schiap. He tries to recover lost ground in the deluge of spray, and he pushes too hard. He spins his boat. Here it is on the replay. Eden quickly recovers and rejoins the race, but with a lot of positions to recover as he's overtaken by Cedric de Guin, Duarte Benavente, and Philip Roms. Roms tries to pass Benavente to move up to 13th, but Benavente holds off the young Finn. Eric Eden quickly finds the speed he needs to climb back from 15th, first passing Philip Roms, then Benavente. Leading the race by 3.87 seconds is Thani Alcamzi. Behind him in second is Peter Morin, then Eric Stark, followed by Celio up in fourth ahead of Stromoy fifth and Cantando in sixth. Stromoy is giving chase to Sammy Celio in fourth, while world standings leader Sean Torrente is in seventh, desperate to move up and overhaul Cantando in sixth, knowing every point counts. Eric Stark also knows the championship title may well come down to a difference of a few points as the Swede stays on Peter Morin's tail, trying to look for any opportunity to pass the Frenchman. Morin is looking very solid. What a year it's been for him, emerging as the top non-Abu Dhabi driver in the championship in 2018, but he still has to fend off the three-time Grand Prix winner Stark behind him. Behind Torrente, Amaravati. Emirati driver Jonas Anderson with Marshalek in ninth, then defending world champion Alex Gorilla, followed by another multiple world champion Philip Shiup and Grant Trask of Australia in 12th. Two-time world champion Sami Seleo has had a brilliant start to the race, up in fourth from 10th. The 2007 and 2010 world champion trying to end what has been a disappointing season on a high to get a good start for 2019. Behind Seleo is Amaravati runner-up Maritz Stromoy. She's got the fin in her sights, but having trouble putting a dent in Celio's lead. Further back, it's Anderson, Marshalek, and then Corella. The four-time world champion must already be looking forward to the next season after having failed to finish four of five races in 2018. Meanwhile, in the lead, possible history in the making if Daniel Kabzi can hold on and hold off all challengers. He wants to be the first local to win the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix in a quarter of a century. No pressure. An ongoing battle for sixth between Cantando, Torrente, and Anderson. Three drivers with a total of 24 Grand Prix wins between them. But it's bad news for Anderson's Amaravati teammate Eric Eden. The young driver is out of the race and towed off on lap 15. Bad luck also for Anderson just a lap later, as his race also comes to a premature end. Both Amaravati drivers are out of the race.
Well, I don't know, we need to check the engine, but I almost flipped in the yellow in the first lap, so I lost all positions, and then I think something inside the engine has blown out. Nothing hit me.
With Anderson out, the battle for eighth is down to Marshalek, being chased by Alex Gorilla. Marshalek trying to get some more points for Emirates Racing Team with a top 10 finish here. With Anderson's exit, Shep now is up in the top 10, then Trask 11 and De Green up in 12. Another duel heats up as Stromoy is under a second behind fourth place Sami Seleo. The Norwegian Emirates racer trying to find a way past the Finnish Mad Truck Baba racing driver. In lap 29, the unthinkable happens as Eric Stark slows down and he pulls over. This is a huge blow to the title hopeful's chances. What a tragedy for Stark, and that leaves his campaign in serious trouble going into the final race in Sharjah with just a maximum 20 points left for grabs. Also out is Alex Corella, a fifth, no finish, and no points showing for the Italian world champion in what has proven to be the most disappointing season of his career. With the race entering the last 10 laps, Daniel Kanzi is holding off all challengers, racing with the determination of someone who knows they may well make history here, while also setting his sights on a possible world title if he can keep this form coming into Sharjah. With Stark out of the race, Sami Seleo is looking to finish in third. He's been a stranger on the podium, and this would be welcome relief for him and Mad Croc Baba Racing. But he knows first he has to hold off some big names like Stromoy, Cantando, and Torrente behind him with just 7 laps to go. But look at Marin, he's right up there chasing Al Kamsi, sensing an opportunity to pass the Abu Dhabi ace. With the laps ticking away, Marin keeps the pressure on race leader Al Kamsi, looking for his first ever F1 H2O win here. Can Al Kamsi keep his nerve under the CTIC Frenchman's pressure? But Al Kamsi is determined. He holds on and holds Marin off, sticking close to the inside, trying to just bring the boat home as they go into the final lap. Daniel Kamsi pulls off an incredible and historic win in Abu Dhabi. What a performance! Daniel Kamsi is the 2018 Grand Prix of Abu Dhabi champion. Marin continues his fairy tale season with another podium as runner-up, and Sami Seleo back up on the podium for Mad Croc Baba Racing. Maritz Stromoy gets another great result with fourth, adding 9 points to her tally. Cantando with his second successive fifth place finish, signaling a change of fortunes for the Italian veteran. Torrente with 5 crucial points in sixth, and that will keep him a nose ahead going into the last round, giving him the psychological advantage in Sharjah. That result means that Team Abu Dhabi are the World Team Champions for 2018, a third team title under manager Guido Cappellini, 131 points. CTIC F1 Shenzhen China. with Emirates Racing in third. What a finale we are in for in Sharjah. Al-Khamzi and Tarente with just a few points between them. Al-Khamzi has won in Sharjah before. Can he do it again? It all comes down to a battle between these teammates. And Stark is also still a hopeful, though his chances are dented by the no points result in Abu Dhabi.
I make extremely good start. Stay with away from the trouble outside, and I had good speed. I got the guys in the first lap, and then it was big fight with the Marit all the time. She was just behind my tail all the time and pushing me, and my radio man Michael Jenkins came back for this race, last two races this season, so was great.
Very happy to be on this situation, and after just follow the first one, try to catch him sometimes. But it was one time near the end, it was very close, but yesterday already one crash, so for this weekend it's okay, only one, it's Enos.
In the World Driver standings going into the last round in Sharjah, Torrente's sixth place finish just manages to give him a slight 3-point lead over Al-Khamzi, where the winner takes all, but Stark still with a shot on 65 points, 12 behind Torrente. Marin solidifies fourth, Chiap still in fifth, with Stromoy continuing her ascent in sixth on 35 points, and Celio boosted up to seventh ahead of Eric Eden.
Thank you very much, I'm very happy I have a good start. I start from the duck third, I turn first point, no one behind me, I look where's the guys, is I'm racing alone or no? And then I push hard, keep the engine safe, finish the race. Little bit last 10 laps, I have problem with the trim bump. The French guy close to me, I can't handle the boat until I say I have only 5 laps. I push very hard, and what happened. And then I finish the race first, alhamdulillah. Wow, 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 wow.